Douglas have played well in spots as well. So you still like to be able to use your bench when you want to, not when you have to. But the Zebras have managed foul trouble really in different parts of all these games. So I'm not sure that's as worrisome of a problem for Coach as it was at the beginning of the season.
The Rochester Zebras in their road blacks, the LewisCass Kings in their home whites. Will be Kiesling and Garrick to jump center. Rochester will go right to left, and the LewisCass Kings left to right. Tony Stasiak, Trey Stasiak. I'm David Musselman. We're at LewisCass High School. And the final game of the 2013 portion of the season is underway as LewisCass controls the tip. Hadley, middle of the floor, works to the right side, drives it right, does pass down low to Omen. His to make that to Jesus. His jumper's good, and that quick. Nora LewisCass on the board, and they do come out in that full court press.
Little diamond 1-2-1-1.
Abbott, got to get it across, and his pass is kicked away by Kiesling. It'll stay with Rochester right at the timeline.
Beavers going to have to really work on spacing. You have a short lineup here yourself. You've got some guys that maybe aren't point guards, but that can help spread the floor and move the ball and try to beat that trap with a pass rather than try to dribble through it.
The inbound pass is knocked away again by Kiesling, and Rochester will try it again. Abbott, the trigger man, on the far sideline. Slaps the basketball and gets it in to Streeton. Carter runs to Holland. Alec for three, left wing. No good. High off the back of the board, and an offensive rebound by Holland. A putback is no good, and Fixler grabs the board. LewisCass runs. Fixler, left side of the floor. Shows the baseline. His up and under move is no good. The rebound to Jesus. His jumper over Garrick is partially blocked. Alec Garrick with the rebound, and he gets it ahead to Holland. Rochester, the numbers, 3-on-2 break. Holland steps up, shoots a 15-footer. No good. Fixler with the rebound. He runs. Fixler ahead to Omen. His jumper is no good. We're going to have a foul before the shot on the floor against Rochester, and it'll be out of bounds to LewisCass.
Well, the first question that we had is definitely answered. LewisCass very comfortable getting the ball up and down the floor off makes or the Zebras haven't made one yet, but off dead balls or live balls, they're trying to push the ball every chance they get.
Fouls
on Garrick. Nope, I'll just say fouls on Garrick. His first, team's first.
So it'll be LewisCass basketball baseline right as Ryan Bixler gets it in. To Omen, now right wing to Kiesling. Push it to Hadley. To Omen for three. Make that Bixler for three is good. Ryan Bixler has 3 points, and LewisCass up 5-0. And the pass is knocked out of bounds by Bixler. And it'll be Rochester basketball right in front of their bench going to our left.
A couple things here, just aside from spacing, is, you know, meeting your pass, using the pass fake, and trying to make good hard cuts to open spots against this trap.
Screen ahead to Abbott on the right side. He has the basketball against the double team out the screen. Quickly to Basham, near side to Holland. Baseline to Garrick. Tim Footer is off the mark, no good. Rebound to Kiesling. LewisCass run. Kiesling fills the middle of the floor. Kiesling now at the elbow. Jump pass to the near side to Omen. Omen will fire three from the right baseline. No good. The offensive putback by Fixler is going to make that. Hadley is going to be waved off. Oh, no. It's going to be on the shot. He's going to be fouled, and he'll go to the line to shoot two.
Fouls on Brett Abbott, his first, team second, and there's an offensive rebound again just simply by outworking the guy to the weak side board.
Rochester will take a timeout. It is a 30. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Fulton County Best One Tire is so much more than just tires. They offer a complete line of service with quality you can depend on. Ask their friendly staff about an oil change, transmission flush, brake service, alignment, or even an engine replacement. Or stop by and see their experts about a custom exhaust. They also keep the area's largest tire inventory in stock. Right now, you can take advantage of great rebate programs. Just call Doug or Todd at 223-2103. Fulton County Best One Tire, where the most important person to them is you. They're located at the corner of Fort Wayne Road and Highway 25 North in Rochester.
Zebra Basketball, WROI. 6:27 to play in the first quarter. LewisCass up 5-0. And at the free throw line is Blake Hadley, a 5'7 senior for the LewisCass Kings with two freebies. First one on the way is no good. He'll have one more. Trey, rebounds at this point?
So far, Rochester has two offensive and no defensive. LewisCass has two offensive and three defensive.
Five rebounds already for the LewisCass Kings. Second one by Hadley's no good again. And Garrett grabs the board. Alec clears himself, middle of the floor. Now picks up his dribble, gets it ahead to Streeton on the right wing. Streeton high on the right side against Kiesling in the man-to-man defense. Dribbles left side, now to Holland at the volleyball line. Against Hadley, now to Garrett on the right wing. Garrett down low to Basham. Basham on the baseline. against the man-to-man defense. Drives the paint, kicks it back outside to Derrick. Now to Abbott High on the right side. Now to Creighton, swings it to Holland in the left wing. Derrick just about got his pocket pick. Gives it to Streeton. Now to Abbott. He drives the paint. Rises up over the Kiesling. His shot's no good. Rebounded to Jesus. And Victor to Jesus. Quickly to Bixler. Bixler in the right corner. Now on the wing to Omen. To Hadley on the left side. Hadley looking for Kiesling on the block. Can't find it. He'll back it out. We'll reset in the center circle. Hadley. Right side to Bixler. Rochester to man-to-man defense. Bixler drives it left in the paint, gives to Kiesling. He runs the baseline. His jumper is good off the glass. 7-0. Cass on top against the full court press. Streeton ahead to Derrick. Around Streeton. Streeton got to hurry. Just does cross the timeline for the 10-second count to Abbott. Kicks it out to Derrick. He'll fire a three right wing. No good. And the rebound is knocked out of bounds by LewisCass and Omenhill, and it'll stay baseline left.
LewisCass just doing a really good job of moving the ball and getting quick reversals. And on that quick reversal, the last guy that gets it, the defense is either a step slow or they're over-rotating, and they're just attacking that weak side baseline.
Fashion loses the basketball out of bounds, and it will go to LewisCass. And Luke Kennedy and Brandon Camp will come into the game for Rochester. Brent Abbott will sit, as will Matt Basham.
If Zebras can get the ball to the big man inside against this defense, and also Luke can help with the rebounding issue, and then maybe Camp can help chase the guards a little bit.
Yeah.
It's like an extended 2-3 zone here by the Zebras.
7-0 LewisCass. Kiesling in the corner. Drives it to the elbow. Pull-up jumper on the way is good. Boy, oh boy, that is smooth. Oh, wow.
I'm just going to use that same word. That's a smooth-looking shot.
And then Rochester turns it over. Kiesling in the paint. Jump pass to Hadley. Layup is good. 11-0. LewisCass with 4:40 to play in the first quarter. And Coach Reinhold will use another timeout. It is a 60-yearless. Hang on a minute. It's a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Plymouth wants you to enjoy your world. And now the basketball, swimming, and wrestling are back. And college and pro football continue. There's plenty to do. So whether it's heading for the gym, holiday open houses, and getting together with friends and family, grab the refreshingly clean taste of Coca-Cola, Diet Coke, Coke Zero, Sprite, and Sprite Zero. Make sure you have plenty of Coca-Cola products on hand, either from the store or the vending machine. Coca-Cola products go great with everything you do. It's the real thing. It's Coca-Cola.
Basketball, WROI.
4:39 to play in the first quarter. LewisCass pitching a shutout right now. It's 11-0 and in a full-court press. And knocks the pass out of bounds, and Rochester will start it again. Tony Stasiak, Trey Stasiak, even Quinn Stasiak here tonight. The pass is knocked away and stolen by Hadley. Hadley goes in for the right-handed layup. It's good. 13-0. Full-court press again. Street on the sideline. Gets it to Garrick. Garrick now to Holland. Now to Kennedy. Kennedy with the basketball. He'll cross the timeline himself through the center circle. Comes to a jump stop to Street High on the right side. Down the corner to Camp. Brandon Camp against the man-to-man defense. Gives the elbow. And Garrick. And Garrick is fouled on the drive. Will they say he was shooting?
It's going to be on the 14.
It'll be on the floor.
His first team's first.
Kennedy gets the inbound pass from Street and Cass is sleeping. And Rochester on the board. It's 13-2. 4 minutes to play in the first quarter. Hadley gets it across the timeline to Bixler. He drives, kicks in the corner to Kiesling. Three on the left baseline. Nope. Rebound fought for to Garrick. Garrick pushes for Rochester. Ahead to Holland on the near side. Holland to Garrick. Top to Streeton. Carter works against Kiesling. One dribble, takes him inside the three-point line to Camp. Brandon Camp pulls down to Holland, top of the key. 3.5 to play in the first quarter. Rochester down 13-2. Streeton drives the paint. Kicks it out to Holland. He'll fire a three from the left baseline. It's good. 13-5. That helped.
This was a Doc Gorder. Good layup by Luke Kennedy. A three by Alec Holland. That's the kind of offense the Zebras need.
But LewisCass has it against Rochester's 2-3 zone. Hadley bounces the basketball in the center circle. Now directs traffic from the top of the key. Works it left. Now goes back right. Jump pass down low to Omen. Layup is good.
LewisCass got the Zebras to help up. They're in that zone, and as that penetration right down the middle, Zebras helped up a little too high, left the guy on the block wide open.
10-point lead again for LewisCass at 15-5. Kennedy gives to Holland. Out top to Streeton. Out of Garrick. Dump pass down low to Kennedy. Kennedy then loses it out of bounds. They're going to say last touch by the Kings. Rochester will keep possession. You want to see Kennedy dribble there and get closer? He just wanted to rise up.
Well, maybe a little bit more of a lead pass with the big man doesn't have to drive it. But you're right. He's comfortable. He can take that shot. Just kind of caught in no man's land.
All in the left corner. LewisCass in the 2-3 zone. Three on the way, left side. No good. Long rebound to Bixler. LewisCass runs up by 10. Bixler hesitates around the defense. Yeah, I think it's a good call. He just was late doing it, was the official. It'll be out of bounds to LewisCass on the far side. 2.5 to play in the first quarter. LewisCass leading 15-5.
Fouls on Brandon Camp, his first, team's third.
Boy, you just can't get caught flat-footed and reaching against this team. They'll make you pay.
Yeah, everybody, regardless of what defense you're in, everybody's going to have to be in a stance and be ready to move. You can't get caught watching the ball. Your guy may cut back door, cut right by you.
Keesling against Garrick. Right elbow, drives the paint. Dump pass down low to Hadley. His jumper's good and a foul.
You know, Zebras are just helping up. LewisCass is doing a nice job penetrating the middle of the lane, and Zebras are just coming up and helping up and leaving the guys on the block. So it's two open and easy layups, and then and one in this case. Fouls on Brandon Camp. That's going to be his second, team's fourth. So Zebras are starting to venture into the foul concerns already, regardless of the score. Brandon Camp has two, Garrick has one, and Abba has one. But four team fouls. I'm not sure you want to put Cass the free throw line a whole bunch tonight either.
Hadley makes the free throw to make it 18-5. And against a double team, Streeton gets it to Kennedy. Kennedy ahead to Camp. Camp misses Holland wide open down low. Now Streeton on the wing. And then gives to Garrick on the volleyball line. Back to Streeton. Swings it too quickly to Camp. Camp top to Holland. Three on the way. Top of the key over. Keesling is short. And the rebound to Omen. Quickly to Hadley. Hadley goes to the basket, throws up a shot. We're going to have a blocking foul on Kennedy. That's going to send Hadley back to the line for two.
Tough call on Luke. I thought he anticipated the charge really well. You got to anticipate to get a charge. You can't react to it. I thought he saw the play coming down. I thought he was in good legal guarding position. But there's only one opinion in the gym that matters in a lot of those scenarios, and he saw it as a block.
Well, he was definitely there in time. I thought he was there in plenty of time, and apparently he was still moving. I don't know. Hadley makes the first free throw. He'll have one more. Street will come out.
Hadley's already at 8. Could have had 10, but he missed his first two free throws.
LewisCass leading Rochester 19-5. Hadley's second one is good again. 20-5 now. The Kings with 1:50 to play in the first quarter. Full court press for LewisCass. Streeton makes that to Garrick. Gives the head to Camp. Camp drives the baseline. Wrap around pass to Kennedy. Outside to Holland. Top to Brett Abbott. Out of Garrick, who drives, cut off by the defense. He throws up a shot and it goes. That's a tough shot. And it went for Alec Garrick. 20-7. LewisCass on top, and their 2-3 zone. Rochester's 2-3 zone meets the ball. Hadley at the free throw, or makes that at the volleyball line. Turnaround jumper for Omen is no good, and Brett Abbott with the rebound, and that's a dangerous pass. Garrick grabs it just before Omen does. And now Kennedy has it right side. Kennedy, pull-up jumper from the elbow, is good.
Luke's got four off the bench.
60 seconds to play, first quarter. LewisCass up 20-9. Keesling back to Hadley. Hadley down low to wide open Omen. Layup is good. I would like to know how many shots LewisCass has hit inside 5 feet.
About all of them.
Yeah. Garrick, and then his foul on the far baseline by either Keesling or Evan Omen.
Foul's going to be on Keesling. That's his first, Cass second. Cass is really making the game look easy now. That dribble penetration, the Zebras are really helping on that. They're just sliding guys back behind it. Either the guy's staying on the block, staying low, and be ready for an easy bounce pass to a layup, or he's sliding back, starting on three-point line, cutting back door on the baseline, and then another layup.
So the inbound pass goes to Holland. Alec Holland crosses the timeline against Hadley. Now gives high on the left side to Abbott. Back to Holland with 35 seconds to play in the first quarter. LewisCass leading 22-9. Holland now dribbles to the high on the right side, about five steps inside the 10-second line, and dribbles down to 22 seconds to play in the first period. Near side to Garrick with 18. Alec holds with 17. Back to Holland with 15. Holland in the center circle. Couple of dribbles against Hadley. Force to the right side with 9 seconds. We're going to have a block on Hadley. I think Coach John Kitchell was anticipating a charge. But it is a defensive foul. It will be out of bounds to Rochester with 9.5 seconds to play in the first quarter.
Yeah, if you weren't going to give it to Kennedy down there, you couldn't give it to that, because that was definitely sliding in him a little bit. So I thought Luke was a little bit more set than Hadley was. So the Zebras 9.5, try to get the last shot, get a good look here to end the quarter on a positive note.
Abbott looks to get it in. Just in the corner to Holland. He'll take the three with 8 seconds. No good. Off the mark. The rebound fought for. And DeJesus comes out with it with three. Gives the head to Irwin. And Irwin cannot get the shot off before the buzzer. After one, LewisCass leads the Rochester Zebras 22-9. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. And we're all
It's all in the name, and at All About Pets, it really is all about pets. All About Pets Downtown Rochester is your locally owned pet store that caters to you and your pet. They work hard to bring the very best in pet supplies to our area. Choose from premium pet foods, pet healthcare supplies, toys and treats, small animal food, pet accessories, fish, and aquarium supplies. That's All About Pets, one block north of the courthouse on Main Street in Rochester. Their only business is to enhance the happiness of your pet. And we're all
Statistics show that 99% of all farms are family-owned. If you're a farmer, you want to make certain that you carry on the family tradition by passing it down to the next generation. Make certain that you protect your heritage by talking to your Pekin Insurance Agency, Jennings Insurance in Rochester and Argus. They'll help you create an estate plan for your farm that will treat all heirs equally, even those who don't farm, and have sufficient funds for income, gifts, and estate taxes. You can do all this and more with the right insurance plan from Jennings Insurance, representing Pekin Insurance. Call 574-224-7777 in Rochester and 574-892-5249 in Argus today about carrying on the family legacy for years to come.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
So over the second quarter, the Kings with a lead of 22-9. The Zebras start with the basketball. Garrick. Force against McRae. Throws up a shot. No good. Rebound to LewisCass. And then Garrick steals the basketball. Gives to Kennedy. Kennedy on the left wing behind the arc. Three steps to Abbott. Now in the corner to Holland. Holland almost has his pass stolen. Camp has it. The elbow. He forces the pass. And Keesling intercepts the pass. But I think we're going to have a foul away from the ball.
Yeah. Foul's going to be on Garrick, I believe. That's his second, team six. So Cass will be shooting free throws the rest of the half. Camp made a nice drive on there, but that's a tough angle to throw into the post from up at the top. If he could have reversed it, the other weak side was wide open.
Keesling over the top of the defense to Irwin. Back to Keesling, top of the key. Down to Irwin behind the arc, left side. Now down low, is tipped away. Irwin gets the basketball back. Keesling has it now and drives. Over the top of the defense to Martin. He'll fire a long jumper. It's no good. Rebound fall for Kennedy. Comes out of there with it. And then baseball pass down the court to Camp. Camp loses the handle. Picks it up. Backs it out. He has his pocket pick. And now LewisCass has it again. Irwin across the timeline for the LewisCass Kings. Now gives the Keesling left side. Keesling drives. Pulls it back out beside the three-point line to Irwin. Down near side to Martin. Martin in the corner to Owen. He'll fire three. It's good. Three-pointer for Evan Owen, a freshman for the LewisCass Kings. Make it 25-9.
And Cass has had six different players score, too, so it's not just necessarily one person.
Camp's three is in and out, no good. And the rebound to LewisCass, and then it's thrown away. Irwin throws it away, gives to Garrick. Garrick shot's good, and a foul. Nice lead pass ahead.
Came from Holland.
By Holland,
yep.
Okay.
Yep.
And
nice.
Garrick, go to the line to shoot two, nice. Or make that one.
Nice look ahead by Holland. Way to stay in the play. It got kind of razzled and kind of chaotic out there. Holland kept his head up, and there Garrick ran the floor and made a nice connection. Now Zebras get one more free throw, get in this lead.
Austin Keesling just picked up foul number two.
Yep, his second, team fourth.
Garrick trying to complete the three-point play, and he does so.
Garrick now has five.
25-12, LewisCass. 6:20 to play. Seabers going to their 2-2-1 trap. And the LewisCass Kings break the trap. Martin in the corner. Travels. Yep. Defense. Good job by the Rochester Zebras.
That's where that trap's pretty effective. It's not necessarily the pressure in the full quarter. It's once they cross that half court line where the trap goes into play. The Zebras ran that well. You got to have good, hard pressure, contain the dribbler, and not always a steal. Sometimes you get somebody a little too quick and get turnover that way.
Trey, rebounds in the first quarter.
So far, Rochester has 2 offensive and 3 defensive. LewisCass has 2 offensive and 9 defensive.
Wow. And Kennedy just hit a 12-footer from the baseline to make it 25-14. Quickly to Bixler. No-look pass to Omen. Back to Bixler in the paint. Leaner over Kennedy is no good. The putback by Cass is no good. And the rebound and the putback by McCray is no good. But Drew McCray will go to the line to shoot two.
There you go. 2 offensive rebounds. 1 possession by Cass. And what ends up happening on that? Loose ball. You got a foul. And it's going to be 2 shots. And more importantly, 2 fouls for Luke Kennedy. As you mentioned, Cass is shooting free throws the final 5:42 of this half. And that's the second foul on Luke Kennedy.
Trey, Quinn's turnovers.
Zebras have 5. LewisCass has 3.
Okay. Tony Stasiak. Trey and Quinn Stasiak. David Musselman with you at LewisCass High School. Don Thomas checks in for the first time. Noah Dahlquist checks in for the first time. Eric will come out, as will Kennedy.
Coach trying to find some answers, trying to find some lineups to work. Obviously, with Luke getting 2 fouls, part of that equation. But, you know, at this point of the game, you're only down 11, not out of it, but you're still trying to find a combination that might work well together, especially taking care of the boards.
McCray hits 1 of 2 to make it 26-14.
7th different cast player to score.
They've all played. 5.5 to play in the first half. Dangerous pass. Camp gets it from Abbott. Gives it Dahlquist. 15-footer. Good. Noah Dahlquist has his first point of the contest. And it's 25-16. Rochester back within 10.
Big man can get in the game and hit that, knock down that shot. That's a big boost to the lead.
Yeah, you're not kidding. And boy, if Dahlquist and Kennedy both can play at the same time, wow.
I'll tell you what, Dahlquist is really impressed with him as he's improved just in this year.
Yeah.
Puts a few more pounds of muscle on, and that's a lethal player waiting to happen there.
Martin's 3-pointer no good, but Hadley's putback is good. And the lead is back to 12 for LewisCass. King still a 4-court press, and then has the inbound pass stolen. Hadley shot good and a foul.
Foul's going to be on Holland. Basket's going to be good. Foul's going to be on Alec Holland, his first, team 8. And Hadley is well into double figures already in the first half. He's got 13 points thus far. Getting ready to add to that, possibly.
He's got 4 points, 5 points in the last 4 seconds.
Yep.
And a substitution as Carter Street will come back in and Brandon Camp will sit down. 4:56 to play in the first half. 31-16 LewisCass, and the Kings still in the full court press. Holland will trigger it in.
Tough thing about this kind of situation is the Zebras trying to find answers, but if the team is pressing and trapping you, these are probably lineups that haven't played a lot together,
yeah.
Especially against a trap in practice, and you know, guys aren't quite on the same page. Frustration pretty high for the guys.
Abbott has his pass knocked out of bounds by Hadley. It'll be Rochester basketball at the timeline right in front of the scorer's table. Screen will look to get it in. Does so to Abbott. Abbott one dribble back to Screen near the timeline. 4:40 to play in the first half. Kings up 31-16. Screen dribbles to the elbow. Now to Holland, just inside the arc. The long jumper is in and out. Back in. 5 for Alec. 31-18. Quickly, Hadley on the left wing. Pulls it out. Now gives to Bixler, top of the key. Bixler around the pick, inside the arc. Now to Omen. His jumper is good from above the free throw line. And Evan Omen has 2 more. Rochester quickly down the floor. Holland pulls up. Jumper, no good. Rebound, LewisCass. Martin with the board, now gives to Bixler. Man, one and done are the Zebras. About every time down the floor. Hadley in the left wing. Bixler top of the key. Back to Hadley. Wide open 3, left side. Nope. Rebound by Abbott. And then Abbott loses it in the hands of Omen. Gives to Martin. Layup, good. 35-18. Full court press by the Kings. Streeton, 1 dribble to Dom Thomas. Down to Abbott, crosses the timeline against Martin, takes him to the wing, outside to Thomas. Near side to Screeton. 3.5 to play in the first half. 35-18. LewisCass. Screeton to the baseline. Outside to Abbott. He'll go to the rack. His shot's good and a foul.
I know we saw Brett Abbott do that earlier in the year. I thought he was playing in the post more, but that's a threat and a weapon that he brings to the table more often is putting the ball on the floor and making something happen. Steelers don't really have it. They haven't shown it, but they break somebody down off the dribble and kick into the paint like that. If Brett can do that, that continues to add to the Steelers' arsenal.
You know, we really haven't seen him do that since Culver.
Right.
And they need him to do that about every game. So Abbott at the line for one free throw. It's good, and it's 35-21. Back into the game is Basham, and Brett Abbott will come out.
Yeah, that's big because, you know, you've got Luke inside. If Alec Collins is going to be an outside shooter only and not really try to drive the paint, you're going to have somebody in that mid-range game, and that's where Abbott can be a valuable asset.
Bixler backs his way inside the volleyball line. Gives to Hadley, back to Bixler. Leaner from the free throw line goes, and it's 37-21.
This cast team just has an answer. Any of the five guys, they all look about the same, and they all do about the same. And it's just, they play really well together, move the basketball. Everybody knows where each other is going to be, and just really impressed with how they're playing together.
37-21, LewisCass, 2:50 to play in the first half. Screeton to the left wing, trying to get away from Hadley. That's not going to happen. And then Screeton loses the basketball, picked up, and he's going to be called for travel. He was getting mugged right in front of the Rochester bench. Coach Reinhold can't believe there wasn't a foul there, and there was a turnover, a travel on Rochester.
I mean, I don't understand how you can call the travel without all that contact that was there before.
So LewisCass gets it back with 2:45 to play in the first half, leading 37-21. Jump pass down low to Bixler. Has it stripped away. Basham has it. Rochester runs down to Holland. Holland left side of the floor. Holland on the wing. Out of Basham. Swings right side to Screeton. Screeton looking for Dahlquist. Screeton a couple of dribbles inside the three-point line. Gives to a cutting Basham. His layup is good. Nice looking shot by the senior. Basham has his first two of the contest. 37-23.
That's a nice little offensive set there. Just that pass and cut through the lane. And good read by Basham.
Oh. Bowman for three. No good. And we're going to have a foul down low, I believe, on Hadley. And Basham hits the floor hard.
Basham hit the floor for LewisCass. Bowman hit the floor hard after his shot. The physicality of this game is dialed up a little bit here these last couple minutes.
Yeah. 2:10 to play in the first half, 37-23. LewisCass, and they're in a full court press. Basham with it in the corner against the double team. Dribbles up the floor, crosses the timeline, outside left. Now gives to Streeton, who crosses the timeline. Now top of the key, crossover dribble the lane. He'll pull up from inside the free throw line. His shot no good. Bixler, the rebound, he runs. Bixler goes coast to coast. The layup is good. 39-23. Full court press again by the Kings. 1:45 to play in the first half. Thomas crosses the timeline between his legs, dribble, works the middle of the floor. Now left side to Streeton. Carter, study against Hadley. Top of the key, now to Holland to the volleyball line on the right side. 90 seconds to play, first half. Rochester down by 16. Street, left side, in the paint. Backs it back outside behind the arc. Picks up a dribble, now to Basham. Basham to Holland on the left baseline against Omen. To Tom Thomas. Takes it out to Basham with 1:15 to play in the first half. To Streeton, fakes a three. Drives in the paint. Leaner off the glass is good.
Something else the Beavers need. Carter Streeton has not shot the ball very much this year. That's a situation where he's driving the paint trying to create something. That's a good sign as well.
Under 55 seconds of play in the first half. It's 39-25. Bixler fakes a three. Gives to Omen. Cross court right to Hadley. To Omen. His three. No. And stuck on the top of the backboard.
Not sure I've seen that. I haven't either. Stuck on the rim. I've seen it be land and be set softly on the rim, but I've never seen it actually get stuck up on the top there.
Folks, you might want to remember this name. Evan Omen. Freshman. Great looking shot.
Yeah. He's got a little bit of the, I call it the Reggie Miller, kick your legs out and maybe try to last couple times and he's falling down.
Yeah.
I don't think you want to do that too much because, you know, you take too many falls and you're risking hurt and trying to bait a call and the Beavers just close it out. Fortunately, the referees have not fallen for that.
Then you turn into Kobe.
Hey, Trey. Thanks for joining the broadcast, buddy. Cast in the full court press. 35 seconds. Ball tipped away and stolen. Halley goes to the rack. Fix where that is. The shot good and a foul.
That's going to be Bixler. He's going to join double figures. Yep, he's got double figures with 12 now, and that foul is going to be on Holland. I believe that's his second. Once again, looked like the young man was in a great spot to take a charge. I don't be interested to know. I think I'd be asking the referees, from Coach Reinhold, what do you guys define as a charge? Because if two attempts the Zebras have made has not been able to get a charge called, then what will?
Makes the free throw to make it 42-25. Garrick with 28 seconds, middle of the floor, splits the double team in the paint, rises up, shot no good, and the rebound to Rochester. Camp with 20, kicks it out to Holland. Holland inside the arc. He'll take the long jumper. No good. Ball tipped around, moves Cass out of there with it. Holman Owen, right side of the floor, splits the double team. Oh, and throws it in between two Zebras, but led on the McRae just a bit too far and out of bounds.
Might be the first time all night where the Cass players have not been on the same page. I think they were. I think the cutter just didn't continue to go.
Yeah.
I think that had a chance to be a nice layup that he kept running.
6 seconds. Holland across the timeline with four. Out to Camp with three. Three on the way. Short. Cast the rebound, and that'll do it. At halftime, Rochester leads. I'm sorry, LewisCass leads the Rochester Zebras 42-25. Halftime show coming up next on 92.1 WROI.
The new Holland year-end clearance event is going on.
Good call. LewisCass will start with the basketball going to our left. And Kiesling back on the floor, and that's one thing we haven't talked about a whole lot tonight, Tony, is Austin Kiesling. He's been really quiet. Well, he's been saddled with some fouls, too.
Yeah, he's got 4 points, but, you know, he's also directing the show and getting everybody else in the right spots and made some nice passes to get those guys some open layups.
Rochester comes out in a 2-3 zone that's extended to the volleyball line. Kiesling to Hadley. In the corner to Bixler. Wide open three. Nope. Too hard. Rebound to Eric. Nope. He loses it to Bixler. Jump pass down to Omen. His layup is good. Now it's a 19-point lead for LewisCass at 44-25. Still in a full-court press. Kennedy starts the second half with the basketball. On the near side, gets to Streeton. Swings left side to Garrick in the corner to Abbott. Abbott left corner. One dribble back to Garrick on the left wing. Now on the right side to Holland. Holland looking down low to Kennedy. Cass doing a good job fronting him. The ball is forced in. And now we're going to have a foul away from the basketball. Who's that going to be on?
I think they called it. Well, I thought they were going to call it a kick.
We're going to have a foul on Kennedy.
Wow. No.
Nope.
No, it's going to be on Hadley. Hadley's, that's going to be his second cast, his first foul. You want to go to the ball and get the ball to Luke Kennedy, but that's a tough angle to throw from the top of the key. Allen's got to throw that pass to the wing, and Kevin Streeton or Garrick, let them make that post-entry feed from the wing and put it at the top.
Garrick throws up a shot, no good, gets his own rebound back. The follow-up is no good. And Bixler with the rebound. Cass runs up by 19. A minute gone in the third quarter. Backs it out and will set up shop. Again, is that a 1-2-2?
I think they're just playing one of the guys on the top of the 2-3 just playing a little higher, I think.
Kiesling 3 is good from the left wing. 47-25. Full court press again by the Kings. I should say still. Abbott threads the needle to Streeton. Middle of the floor to Garrick. Pull up 12-footer. Too hard. Bixler with another rebound.
Good possession, though, by the Zebras. They did get the ball to the middle, finally gets that press, and got a good look at the end.
And then Hadley gets a great pass from Bixler to put it in for two easy ones. Kennedy now right side. Kennedy pull-up jumper over to Jesus is in and out, and no good. Rebound to Omen to Hadley. Hadley runs for Cass. Right side of the floor, coast-to-coast, foul of the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
Foul's going to be on Streeton, his first, team's first of the half. Mr. Hadley now has 16 to lead all scorers in the game. And again, I think just about all of them have come from inside 5 feet.
Yeah, you're right. Coach Reinhold will use a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra.
It's just nonsense the way some water softener companies claim electricity is the only thing that matters when it comes to better water. Culligan embraces technology. Their water softeners use $3 a year in electricity. That $3 a year powers their smart sensor, the brain of the softener, so it recharges only when needed. That means you don't waste salt or water the way brainless non-electric softeners do. Start saving today by calling Culligan of Fulton County, 574-223-2420, and trying the smarter solution to hard water for only $10 a month. Culligan, better water, pure and simple.
Dean Foods have been supplying dairy products to America's table since 1925. They're proud to bring you outstanding dairy products that promote a healthy living for you and your family. Everyone needs calcium, and dairy products are the purest way to get your daily requirement. When shopping, load up on the perfect foods. Dairy products from Dean Foods, Rochester. Dean Foods, created by nature, delivered by Dean.
Basketball, WROI.
6:14 to play in the third quarter. Rochester now down to the LewisCass Kings, 49-25, as LewisCass starts the second half, Tony, on a 10-0 run.
Yeah, you know, we talked about chipping that lead to get it to 10 at the end of the third, and within 2 minutes, a 10-0 run. Now you're down 24. One of those things where a lot of adversity facing the Zebras right now. How are they going to respond?
Hadley at the line for two. First one's good. Here's what I see out of LewisCass. Any one of those kids in a white jersey looks for their shot. Every one of them looks for their shot. They're a great ball-handling team, and every one of them look to score.
And they look for each other.
Yeah.
I mean, a lot of they've passed up some good looks or great looks for a teammate. That's the other thing I'm impressed with. They all know where everybody else is out on the floor, and very unselfish and willing to give up a good look so a teammate can get a great one.
And they have had all sorts of great looks from about 5 feet in tonight. Hadley makes both free throws to make it a 51-25 game. Garrick's shot's no good. Kennedy's putback is no good. Parsley blocks from behind. He gets it back, and putback is good.
8 for Luke.
51-27, LewisCass. 5:40 to play in the third. Rochester in the 2-3 zone. Hadley gives to Bixler. Drives, jump pass back to Hadley. 3 left wing, in and out, no good. Hadley with a rebound. Boy, that looked good from my vantage point.
All these guys have nice form, too, on their shot.
And then his pocket's picked. Keeling has it. To Bixler. Layup. Good. 53-27. Full court press still by the Kings. Garrick. Ahead to Abbott. Abbott. Cross lane pass is kicked out of bounds by Bixler. And Rochester will keep possession baseline right. And Brandon Camp back in the game for Rochester. And Brent Abbott will sit down. 5:09 to play in the third. LewisCass on autopilot right now. They're up 53-27. Streeton gets it in to Holland. Holland fakes the three, gives the Streeton to the baseline. Passes it up to Holland. Now to Camp, top of the key. Now to Kennedy at the free throw line. Kennedy now at the elbow. Turnaround jumper over to Jesus. It's good. Luke Kennedy has 10, and it's 53-29.
Nice Hadley. By Luke getting that turnaround jumper again from the elbow. Calming everybody down when Luke gets going.
Alley's supposed to double team. He's in the paint. No look pass to Kiesling. 3 left baseline. Yep. 56-29. Luke Cass.
Kiesling just became the third cast in double figures. He only had 4 at half. He's got 2 threes this quarter. He's got 10.
Kennedy will fire his own 3. In and out, no good. Oman with a rebound. Victor Oman runs down the floor for LewisCass. Left side. Now top to Hadley. That make that Bixler. Now to Hadley in the right corner. Left wing to Kiesling. 3 again. Why not? Good again. Third 3 of the quarter for Mr. Kiesling. Baseball pass inbounds to Garrick. Crosses the timeline. Middle of the floor. Down low. Goes to the paint. Throws one high off the glass. No good. Hadley skies to the board and runs the other way. 59-29. LewisCass lead. Kiesling again. 3 from the left wing. In and out. No good. Rushes shot that time a little bit. Now Camp has it. Camp will go coast to coast. His jumper over. Kiesling. Bixler. Good and a foul.
Nice job. Coaches talked about Brandon Camp going 100 miles an hour. Sometimes those fast. He did a good job. He used his quickness, but he slowed down towards the end, so he was under control and able to get the and one. Foul's going to be on number 14, Bixler, his second. Team second. Camp going to line. That's his first 2 points, trying to make it 3.
3:48 to play in the third quarter. LewisCass up 59-31, and Camp with 1 free throw, and it goes. 59-32.
One thing the Zebras have done well is shoot free throws, 3 for 3 tonight.
Hadley to Bixler. Works right side. Crossover dribble now left wing to Hadley. Looking down low to Jesus. To Bixler for 3. Good heaven. 62-32. LewisCass up now by 30. And in a full court press. Kennedy then is fouled on the reach in. It'll be out of bounds to Rochester again with 3:23 to play in the third quarter. Matt Basham back into the game, and Alec Garrick will sit down.
Luke's trying to do what he can. I mean, struggle with the press, and why not? You know, the big guy probably ideally don't want your big man to be the one that's got to break the pressure, but, you know, he's got the matchup, and he's at least trying to get the ball across half court. And Beavers will inbound it right at half court.
Streeter looks to get it in around Kiesling. Just through the Basham, back to Streeter, drives the paint, leaner against Kiesling, goes! 4 for Carter, 32-62-32. Hadley loses the basketball in the paint, picked up by Basham, 62-34, beg your pardon, out of Holland. Right side to Streeter. Streeter drives again in the paint, leaner against Kiesling, is no good, but Kiesling just picked up foul number 3.
Yeah, you're right, it's going to be his third, and Carter Streeter all of a sudden trying to pick up his offensive game. One of those, you know, sometimes as a senior, things aren't going well, somebody's got to make some plays out there, and Carter has driven the ball aggressively last couple of times. He scored last trip down, now he's going to go to the free throw line, chance to shoot 2.
62-34, LewisCass, and Carter Streeter goes the line to shoot 2. Well, if nothing else comes out of this game, Carter Streeter now looks to drive, looks to drive the paint to either go in for the layup or pulls up and to shoot. This is the most he's shot all year.
Yeah, it has. And it combined, I mean, in all games, which is a good sign because you want teams to have to be able to respect and defend everybody and, you know, just add to that offensive depth if you can at least take shots that are within your comfort zone.
Basham gets the rebound. 3 for Holland. No good. Too high off the rim. Camp with the rebound. Ball loose from the floor. Scramble for it. Say it, Tony.
It's a scrum.
And we're going to have a tie-up. And it will stay with Rochester.
Good hustle. Again, another senior, Brandon Camp. Maximum effort there, just flying in, trying to keep the ball alive. Looks like he may have drawn a foul on the rebound, but was not called. Stayed with it. Got a tie-up. Zebras maintain possession.
Back into the game for LewisCass is Jake Martin. Streeter, baseline left, triggered in. Does so to Thomas. He loses the basketball to Owen. Owen then ahead to Hadley. Hadley goes in for the layup, and he is fouled while doing so, and that's going to send Hadley to the line to shoot 2 for the Kings with 2:48 to play in the third. LewisCass up by 28.
Grant Camp going to pick up his third foul, and Zebra's second of the half. Zebra's done a good job staying out of foul trouble. That's the problem. Once you do that, you had to play a zone, and you've opened up the perimeter game for Cass.
Blake Hadley, just from the free throw line alone, he's in double figures. He makes one. He'll have one more.
This is his 8th free throw attempt. Oh, 10th. 10th free throw. He's 8 for 10 from the line.
Cass in the full court press.
Sorry, he's got 20.
And a 30-point lead for LewisCass. Thomas from the free throw line, short. Rebound by Owen. Ball loose. Holland has it now for Rochester. Holland now between the rings. Gives the Camp high on the right side. Camp holds. Holland top of the key. 2:25 to play in the third. 64-34, LewisCass. Holland at the elbow. Out to Streeter. Down to Camp on the left baseline. Camp back to Holland. Or make that Thomas. Swings right side to Basham. Basham looks from the baseline to Streeter, can't get it to him. Now has him on the baseline. Drives it left at the elbow. Backs his way in against the defense. Out to Basham. To Camp high on the left side. Streeter drives in the paint. And he's going to be fouled on the way to the basket. And it'll be out of bounds to Rochester with 2:02 to play in the third. LewisCass leading by 30.
Foul's going to be on Omen, his second, team 5th. Another good sign, Carter trying to drive and make a play. Don Thomas doing a nice job posting up really strong. Haven't been able to connect with him, but he's been had some good post position. Zebras just haven't been able to get the ball to him.
Camp to Streeter. Under 2 to play in the third. Streeter middle of the floor. Camp behind the arc, right side, back to Streeter between the rings. Streeter direct traffic against LewisCass, 2-3 zone. Now Camp in the corner to Holland, wide open, 3 on the way, no good. And the rebound to Holland, he loses it. Picked up by DeJesus, he's fouled by Basham.
It'll be Basham's first and team's third. Alec Holland really struggled shooting ball. I don't think he's got 5 points. He made a 3 in the first and 2 in the second, but seems like he's missed his last 5 or 7 shots.
Martin's on the floor, kind of holding that right knee a little bit. We're going to take a 30-second timeout, Paul. Back with more from LewisCass on 92.1 WROI.
Just as coaches and team players need to have excellent communication skills to win games, so do you when it comes to all of your telecommunication needs. At RTC, they strive to bring you the very latest technology when it comes to telephone, high-speed internet, and cable television. Call them at 223-2191 and ask to speak with one of their knowledgeable, helpful, and local customer service representatives. And be sure to catch all the excitement with RTC's NFL Red Zone. RTC, local products, local support, local investment.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Back at LewisCass High School, Will Martin is up. He's walking off under his own power, but limping on that right leg. So they were doing knee tests on him. What did you say, ACL?
Yeah, it looked like, just by the way, the trainer was trying to do that stability test, trying to test out the ligament, see how stable it was. Hopefully, you know, the fact they can walk off, maybe a good sign. But again, the ACL, you know, when you tear it, it's not necessarily you can't put any weight on it. It's just how stable that ligament is. So hopefully for that young man, you know, he's works out okay, and it's not a serious injury.
So the Kings have the basketball with 90 seconds to play in the third, up 64-34. DeJesus fouled on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
Just good, quick ball movement. Zebras came out to pressure, and once again, as they've done all night long, Cass making that extra pass, keeping their head up, knowing everybody else is on the floor. DeJesus wide open underneath, makes the pass. Basham picks up the foul, his second, team fourth. DeJesus going to the line, shoot, first free throws of the game. He had two.
Free throw by DeJesus is in and out, no good. Tony Tran, Quinn Stasiak, David Musselman with you at LewisCass High School. Last game of the 2013 portion of the regular season. Next time Rochester will be in action will be at home against Fairfield in a holiday tournament. Then the consolation and championship games will be at Northwood on the 4th. Full court press by Rochester. DeJesus makes one of two. I'm sorry, full court press by the Kings. DeJesus and Rochester breaks the press as Camp has the top of the key. Camp directs traffic. Left side to Streeton. Streeton drives it to the elbow, right to Camp. Camp at the baseline to Holland. Holly step back three on the way. No good. Rebound fall four. Rochester comes out of there with it. We have a loose ball to four. Basham comes out of there with it to Camp. Under a minute to play in the third. 31-point lead for LewisCass. Thomas down low against DeJesus. Loses the handle. Picked up by LewisCass. Ball still loose. Basham there again to pick up the loose ball against Thomas. Drive. He's swatted from behind. DeJesus picks it up. DeJesus throws some elbows. No call. Now Hadley runs for LewisCass. Hadley, outside right. Stop. Accelerates the lane. Fouled going to the basket. And it'll be out of bounds. He was on the floor on the foul.
Had about 10 fouls in the last 30 seconds. I guess that one must have drawn blood, which is why it was called. Team foul. Let's see. Who was that on? Camp? I'm not sure who that is. Yeah, Camp.
Yeah.
Camp just picked up his fourth. And Zebra's fifth of the half.
37.9 to play in the third. It's 65-34. LewisCass. The Kings with the basketball now with 35. Irwin holds above his head on the left wing. Back to Hadley. Hadley backs it out and will reset for LewisCass in the center circle with 25 to play in the quarter. Up by 31. Hadley to Omen. Evan. Omen. Top of the key. Dribbling. Directing traffic. Has this pass knocked out of bounds by Camp. With 17.4 to play in the third quarter.
Nice work by Brandon Camp to stay in a defensive stance, get his hand in the passing lane, and get that deflection.
Destin Irwin will look to trigger it in around Brandon Camp. Does so to Hadley near the Rochester free throw line with 15 seconds. Hadley across the timeline to 13. Now pulls up, will set up the offense with 10. Crossover dribble takes him left with 8. To Evan Omen for 3 with 7. No good. Rebound by Omen. His brother putback no good with 2. The putback by Evan Omen is good. And that'll do it for the third quarter. After 3, LewisCass leads 67-34. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Got credit. Come and get it. Mike Anderson, Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram of Rochester, has your back when it comes to financing a car. We finance almost everyone. Credit challenged? Come and get it. Bad credit or no credit? Come and get it. Why are we so sure we can finance you? Mike Anderson owns the finance company. There's no middleman. Let Mike Anderson give you the fresh start you deserve today. And right now, during the Big Finish 2013, is your best chance. Choose from hundreds of new and certified pre-owned cars at Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram, all prepared to sell out. Like a new 2014 Dodge Dart SE for only $19,303. Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram is waiting to finance your next car at 1702 Main Street in Rochester or at MikeAnderson.com. Remember, we've got credit. Come and get it at Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. To qualified buyers with approved credit, see dealer for details.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Fourth and final quarter, LewisCass High School. The Kings leading 67-34. Quinn Stasiak, you have scores from around the area.
Yeah, I do. Peru 10, Southwood 10, boys end of first quarter. Wabash 13, Northfield 9, girls end of first quarter. Pioneer 17, Argus 14, boys half. Logan Sport 25.
McCutcheon.
Boys end of first quarter. Valley 37, Witco 23, girls half.
Do that again.
All of them?
No. Valley.
Oh, Valley.
All of them.
Valley 37, Witco 23.
Girls at half. Thank you. Well, as we were listening to scores, Alec Eric goes to the basket hard and makes one out of Pittsburgh. He goes down 69-36.
If Valley girls beat Witco tonight and Northfield beats Wabash, there's only one team that's undefeated in TRC right now.
That'd be Rochester.
That would be.
Pixler. Devin Owens, three, in and out, no good. Rebound to Streeton. Streeton up the floor. He'll fire a three from the wing. Short. Kerrigan the rebound, and he'll put back a 10-footer. Short. Pixler with the board. Pixler, middle of the floor. Right side to Irwin. He hesitates. Dribbles up behind the three-point line. Has it stolen by Holland. Alec Holland has his pocket picked, but he gets it back in the paint. That gives it to Abbott. Layup is no good. Holland's putback no good. Pixler with a rebound. And a Kiesling who's back in the basketball game. 69-36. LewisCass on top. Kiesling. McCray has a shot blocked by Kennedy. And Kennedy then lays out Pixler.
You know, a lot of frustration about these guys are trying to make a play. And kind of the way the officials have kind of been calling, or if they're not calling the second half, it's starting to get a little bit chippy. You know, obviously guys want to impress coach. They want to show they're not giving up. They're playing through. But you also don't want anybody to get hurt out here.
Right.
Got to play hard, and hopefully the officials can kind of clean this up and maybe call it a little bit tighter, at least for a minute or two, just to get the guys back under control.
2-3 zone by the Zebras. Irwin top to Bixler. Bixler crossover in the paint. Kicks it outside for Kiesling for three. In and out, no good. And screen to the rebound. Carter with the basketball for Rochester, going to our right to Abbott. He's at in the paint. He jump stops. He rises up, puts it in. 36. Makes that 69-38.
Abbott's got five.
5:50 to play in the game. LewisCass with the basketball. Kiesling dribbles the left wing. Rochester extends that 2-3 zone to the volleyball line. Pixler around the defense, outside to Kiesling. Kiesling in the paint, rises up at the elbow, throws up a shot. Kennedy with a rebound.
Tell you how many rebounds Kennedy got.
He has three defensive and two offensive.
Okay, so he's got five. He's got the double points, double figures in points. He's got 10, five rebounds.
And then we have a foul down low. Looks like it's going to be whistled against Evan Oman. And now both teams shooting from here on out. Camp back into the game. Screen will sit down. And now LewisCass will take a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 98.1 WROI.
Your Fulton County REMC is proud to offer the new Faster Exceed satellite internet service. They can now connect customers to their fastest satellite internet service ever with broadband speeds up to 12 megabytes per second. For homeowners with fewer options for internet service or who live in rural areas, there's no better option than Exceed Broadband. Share photos remarkably fast. Enjoy better video chat with less jitter. Send and receive files quickly. Exceptionally fast web browsing and email. Listen to streaming music. If you're ready for a faster internet connection, you're ready for Exceed Broadband. Call 574-223-3156 today to learn more about the amazingly fast Exceed Broadband service offered by your local Fulton County REMC, your Touchstone Energy provider.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
5:23 to play in the game. LewisCass leading the Rochester Zebras 69-38. And LewisCass takes the timeout. It'll be out of bounds to Rochester when we resume.
So here we got, in terms of Rochester, going to get to the free throw line. Keep attacking the basket. You know, you can't worry about what's going on now. Don't worry about the point spread at this point. You know, you're playing to continue on and get through this game. So make your defensive reads. Rebound the basketball, pass who's open. Let's just kind of get a, maybe win this final 5 minutes and get some momentum carried over to the holiday tournament.
Kennedy jumper in the paint, too long. Fixler comes flying in out of nowhere to grab the board, then leads ahead to Irwin. Left the layup, just good. Wow. 71-38, and we've got to be at LewisCass's average for the year.
Every Cass player has scored now. Irwin was the first one that had to score.
From the baseline, and about four bodies hit the ground. And I think we're going to have a foul on LewisCass, and that's going to send Rochester to the free throw line. It looks like...
No.
It's going to be on foul. It's going to be on Rochester. Beg your pardon.
Derek's third. He's seven, so Cass is shooting the rest of the way now as well. Both teams are in that situation here.
A tick under 5 minutes to play in the basketball game. LewisCass up 71-38. Noah Dahlquist comes back into the game, and Alec Herrick will sit down.
You know, Dahlquist has looked impressive in some JV action we saw. You know, saw him step out, knock down an outside jumper varsity action tonight. This is a nice, different look for Rochester. Kennedy and Dahlquist playing at the same time.
Yeah, you're right. And I was kind of wondering what that would look like.
Yeah, we're going to get maybe an extensive dose of what that looks like. Get a double post going for the Z's and see if we can't get the ball inside a little bit.
Boy, it's been a long time since Rochester's had that option.
Right. Okay. They haven't had size, a lot of size in general, but let alone have two what we would call legitimate real post players.
Yeah.
You know, Abbott's played there and that, but to have actually two legitimate post players for the guys has not happened in a while.
So McCray makes both free throws for LewisCass to push the score to 73-38. Cam drives, jump stop, rises up, shot blocked by McCray, picked up by Fixler. Fixler, middle of the floor, picks his way through traffic, no look pass down low to Owen. His shot no good, the putback by McCray is no good. Owen gets a rebound, and he is tackled by Kennedy, and that's going to be an intentional.
Just been a frustrating night for Luke. Can kind of tell with his body language, did not start the game, and unfortunately for a young man, just not been his night, and that's kind of the epitome of that. Just a foul you cannot commit in this situation. It may not be your night. You may be struggling. Your team may be struggling. But, you know, Luke's a better player, better person than that. And you don't want to get anybody hurt at this point of the game. That's just not the kind of player you want to be or you want your program to be known as.
So Evan Owen will be at the line to shoot two free throws with 4:37 to play in the game. LewisCass up 73-38. Owen fires the first one, is good. One more. Just a freshman is Owen. Evan Owen.
7 points. 7 points. Yeah. Look at a different Rochester lineup. Kennedy comes out. You're going to have Dahlquist, Basham, Abbott, Thomas, and Holland as your five players here. When as Owen knocks down the second free throw.
That was on the foul. Right?
Yeah. So now we're going to stay up the line, and I can see if should be here in the bonus.
Well, yeah, there wasn't a technical, I guess. It wasn't intentional, which means two free throws on the foul, right? And then
two free throws in the ball to bounds. So Lewis, right. Yeah, it's not an extra foul. They got the two free throws. Nobody's free throw line because it's just two fouls anyways. But the reward on the intentional is you also get the ball back.
4.5 to play in the game. LewisCass up 75-38. Kiesling in the free at the volleyball line against Abbott. Crossover dribble with the elbow. out to Hadley, who backs it out. We'll run some clock for LewisCass. Now right side to Irwin with 4:15 to play in the game. Irwin against Basham. Just past the Kiesling, loses it to Payne-Hill brother. And then he was fouled. He let some of the stuff go that has gone tonight, and then they call that. That's just four.
Yeah, it's going to be Al Collin on that, too. Okay. Well, you get that every once in a while. Okay, a dramatic foul is an intentional foul, just was, and the referee is going to be a little more hypersensitive of that and clean that up a little bit more. So I would anticipate probably some quick whistles here, kind of get this game back under control. Kiesling knocks it down. He only had four at half. He now has 14. He had three threes in the third quarter, and that's a free throw. And this is that.
And Basham with a rebound to Holland. Four to play in the game. The 30-point lead for the LewisCass Kings. Abbott backs his way in the lane, throws up a shot, hangs on the rim, no good. Basham with a rebound. He has it stripped away then by Irwin, and Basham will go to the line to shoot one of the bonus.
Yep, there you go. Like I said, that's probably a foul that hasn't been called. Took a lot more to get a foul call through most of this game, but with recent events, I think I call three officials. We'll click on the whistle now.
Basham ready. Hasn't attempted many free throws this year. He misses the first one. Evan Owen clears the board, gives the Kiesling. LewisCass brings it up the floor to our, going to our left. 3:45 to play in the game. Kiesling splits a double team. Here, the teardrop shot, no good. And Abbott clears the board. And gives off to Holland. 76-38, LewisCass. Holland at the elbow, has it stripped away, and Kiesling picks up foul number four. Holland will go to the line to shoot one of the bonus.
Be clear on the bench here for Cass. I mean, you're going to win this game. I don't know what the schedule looks like, but I think the last thing you'd want is to have one of your starters on the floor with 3 minutes to go and
up 40.
Yeah.
And get hurt. Yeah, you're right. Holland for one of the bonus. Nope, they're going to call it a shooting foul. All right.
Good. Beavers struggled from the free throw line a little bit last night. They're continuing that. They've shot seven free throws only, but they're only 3-for-7. Holland's got one more here.
Second one by Holland is no good, too hard. And Don Thomas keeps that ball alive, gives back to Holland for three. No good, high off the back of the rim. Ball fought for it. Dahlquist comes out of there with it, and he's going to be tied up. And it's going to go to LewisCass.
Holland has just had a shooting night. I mean, he's only made two field goals. I bet you he hasn't hit a shot since early in the second quarter. He's probably now missed, I'd say, his last 10 shots, missed two free throws there. Just a struggling shooting night. I think he may have let the officials call the non-call kind of get under him a little bit.
Dahlquist in the paint. Jumper, nope. The putback, nope. Rebound fall for. Passion comes out of there with it. Matt Rice, jumper good. As Cass is hanging on an arm.
Yeah, nice job by Matt Basham to keep working and staying with it and getting that garbage bucket there.
76-40, LewisCass with the basketball. Hadley around the defense in the paint. Comes it out to Irwin. He's in the paint. He's fouling the shot, and it goes.
Are they counting the basket? Yes, they are. Okay, so Irwin didn't score until the fourth quarter. He's now got four. Chance to hit a free throw, make five. Fouls on Basham. Basham's got third. Team's tenth, so Cass will be shooting two on every foul the rest of the way.
Free throw by Irwin's good.
Irwin now has five.
79-40. 3 minutes to play in the game. Holland is done for the night. Camp back in.
And Brandon Camp, an extended look here at the point guard spot. Will help from Abbott.
And then throws it behind a cutting Abbott out of bounds. Camp to get it back.
Yeah.
How many turnovers is that, Craig? I got a feeling we quit taking turnovers.
Stats are, as always, they're unofficial.
The stats have, that guy's
14,
a check count.
Beavers have 14 turnovers.
Really?
Okay.
And LewisCass has 9.
Okay, cool. Thank you. 2:40 to play in the game, 79-40. Irwin, jump pass down low. And the shot is good, and we don't have that number. Josh Rankert.
He's got two. He's in the book.
Dom Thomas, top of the key, 2:20 to play in the game. A 41-point lead for the LewisCass Kings. Have it at the elbow, has it picked. And Bowman running. Ahead to Irwin, right-handed layup is good. If he doesn't block it, he's going to be in double digits here soon.
He's got seven all in this quarter.
Camp has his pocket again, ball loose, fights for it. Camp comes out of there with it, gives to Abbott. Dump down low to Dahlquist. His jumper's good. Noah Dahlquist with two more.
Dahlquist has four. Great post move. Never brought the ball down. Went up to get the ball, kept it up there, turn around, and got the nice look off the
glass. He's been working hard.
Yep.
Not only this year, but he's made himself a very good ball player. Minute 45 to play in the game, and McCray travels. Bashes his little hip as he's in the midair. Screen back in, Abbott to sit. 1:44 to play in the game. It's 83-42, LewisCass.
Still going to let Camp run the point, get some experience here. Good experience for Dahlquist, Dom Thomas. Basham getting a little extended run here.
Thomas, the screen high on the left side.
Try to get the ball to Dahlquist. How about that?
I agree.
Get the big man to look inside.
Got a steal by LewisCass. Rickett. Riker picks it up to Owen. He'll back it out with a minute 20 to play. Three away from the Kings. Oh, I thought that was going to go. The putback by McCray is no good. And he is fouled on his second opportunity by Basham. And that's going to send Drew McCray to the line to shoot two.
Basham's fourth. Zebra's 11th of the half.
Seriously, you know how many pictures I've ever had taken of me when I'm doing radio?
None.
You know how many pictures your boys have gotten tonight? More than none.
Well,
yeah, tell me. McCray's first one. Good. 84-42, a minute 15 to play in the game.
Probably coming to a scrapbook near you.
Trey, real quick. Figure the total turnovers for Rochester and LewisCass.
Turnovers?
No, I'm sorry, that's turnovers. I'm sorry, the rebounds.
Rebounds.
Rochester with the basketball. Screen gives to Basham near the Rochester bench. Go ahead.
Rochester has 13 offensive and 16 defensive.
29 rebounds, right? Basham, layup, good.
Good.
LewisCass has 11 offensive and 25 defensive.
Yeah, the shorter team is really taking care of the boards on both ends. Yeah.
Irwin drives, throws up a prayer, no good. Dahlquist with the rebound, 28 seconds. To Thomas, to Camp, and then Camp is knocked into the bench by Owen. I'm sorry, by Omen.
It's going to be his fourth.
And I believe that's going to send Camp to the line for two free throws with 23.7 to play in the game.
Yep. Camp has 3 points. He's got two and a free throw. Trying to get to five.
Kings up by 40.
You know, weekend's not going to end the way the Zebras wanted, but a good weekend for Brandon Camp.
Yeah, definitely. I agree.
Yeah.
I'd say the positives from this game. No Dahlquist in the paint.
Yep.
And Carter Streeton finally got the shot to look for his shot.
Yep. Camp coming along, give him a solid minute. This was, you know, tough. But I'll tell you what, when Benita comes back, you're just adding to that depth.
Yeah.
You know, not going to hesitate to bring a Brandon Camp in. Dahlquist is showing you he can play at this level a little bit. Just kind of building that depth. And tough night tonight, but the Zebras approach tomorrow, the next day the right way. You can take this tough night and hopefully have less tough nights down the road.
Camp hits both free throws. Irwin with seven. Dribbles near the timeline with six. Gets a double team. Gives to Omen with two, and that's going to do it. The LewisCass Kings defeat the Rochester Zebras tonight on the road, 84-46. Post game thoughts after this on 92.1 WROI.